Hello guys, this is Avinash and you are watching Everything Metallurgy. With the last lecture, we have discussed material balance and also finished iron making. So in this video, we are going to start the basics of steel making. It's nothing but the steel making overview. We'll be starting the steel making overview today. In the coming 5 to 6 lectures, we'll discuss about all the different processes that are taking place in steel making. Okay, so firstly, what is steel? Steel is nothing but it is generally a type of component that is present in iron carbon diagram. That means steel belongs to iron carbon system, you can say. Or steel is a component or it is a solid solution of carbon in iron. Okay, that is generally steel, and it is again classified into some types. So the main classification is plain carbon steels and alloy steels. In the name itself, you can indicate that the major constituent of the steel is only carbon in plain carbon steel, whereas here in alloy steels there are some other elements, generally like Engg, vanadium, tungsten, chromium, nickel. Okay, we'll see what are the effects of these alloying elements or effects of impurities. If these are present in excess in plain carbon steel, then these are known as impurities also. So okay, so we'll discuss what are the effect of these impurity atoms also. So similarly, here in plain carbon also there is again three type of steels: low carbon steel, medium carbon steel and high carbon steel. Okay, that means low carbon, in low carbon steel the carbon content is less than 0.25. the carbon content in low carbon steel is less than 0.25%. Then it is known as low carbon steel. Okay, if the carbon content is between 0.25 to 0.6, then it is medium carbon steel. Similarly, if it is greater than 0.6%, it is called high carbon steel. Okay, depending on the carbon percentage, we'll be varying the steel properties, will be varying a lot. Okay, generally low carbon steels have excellent ductility and toughness, whereas while increasing the carbon content, the steel becomes hardest and strongest and least ductile. Okay, so always remember, the percentage of carbon is directly proportional to the strength of the steel, or you can also say the hardness. Okay, and it is inversely proportional to the ductility. Okay, so this is about the type of carbon steels, and you can find some examples also, like common products like nuts, bolts, sheets, which doesn't require that much strength, are these low carbon steels. Whereas for somewhat higher strength applications, like in any machine, any machinery, automobile parts, any agricultural parts like gear, axles, etc., medium carbon steels are used. Similarly, high carbon steels are the most strongest and hardest, so these can cut other materials. Okay, so because of its more strength and hardness, and also of its wear resistance, these are used, these high carbon steels are used in cutting tools. Okay, cutting tools, musical wires, strings. Okay, these are generally used as musical wires also. So these are the brief explanation about low carbon, medium carbon and high carbon steels. Okay, one more thing, I talked about impurities. Whether the steel is plain carbon, whether it is plain carbon or alloy steel, that means any type of steel contain impurities, common impurities such as sulfur, phosphorus, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen and silica, that is SiO2. Okay, and sometimes there is also manganese. These are different impurities. Generally, we'll be studying to control these impurities in steel making. how to control these impurities content in the steel, how to reduce them. That is what we are going to study in this module. Okay, so sulfur, phosphorus, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, silica and manganese, these are the different impurities that can be found in all type of steels. Okay, regardless of the classification, in any type of steel these impurities can be found. So now let's see what are the effect of these impurities, what are the different effects of these impurities. Effect of these impurity elements. The first one, carbon, we have already discussed. It is not impurity generally, but it is a solute atom. Okay, so it generally imparts strength to the iron. I will explain this, strength to the steel or iron. Okay, and it reduces the ductility. Fine. And the main importance of this carbon is it allows heat treatments. Okay, heat treatments are one which are helpful in modifying the properties of the material by varying its microstructure and its components. Okay, and carbon is the principal element that allows these heat treatments. Okay, that is about carbon. The major impurity is sulfur. Sulfur, it generally segregates during the solidification. Okay, it segregates and it causes hot shortness. Hot shortness is nothing but at high temperatures the liquids will be not mixing. Okay, that means the solidification rates differ because of the formation of some elements or compounds, sorry, like FeS. During the solidification these inclusions lower the properties, like inclusions such as FeS cause hot shortness. Hot shortness is nothing but it, while solidification, it doesn't allow uniform solidification throughout. Okay, that is hot shortness. And these inclusions also have some other negative impacts. Those are nothing but it reduces the weldability and also it reduces the corrosion resistance of the steel. That is about sulfur. So sulfur is the most dangerous impurity element. And the next important one is phosphorus. Phosphorus also does the same thing. It segregates during the solidification and it impairs the plastic properties. That means it decreases the ductility or brittle nature will be imparted to the steel because of this phosphorus. Okay, similarly silicon, if you talk about silicon or silica, generally silicon will be in the form of SiO2. Okay, so it reduces the drawability. What is this drawability or drawing capacity? We'll discuss in the slag. This SiO2 is an acidic oxide which increases the viscosity. Okay, because of increase in this viscosity, the drawing ability, generally we know wires are drawn from steel. That is the major, one of the major application of steel. So this drawing capability or capacity is decreased because of increase in viscosity, that is because of silicon. Okay, and some amount of manganese, we talked about manganese, and some amount of manganese is required because this affects the ductility. I mean, this increases the toughness and sharply reduces this hot shortness. That means it helps these compounds to break into different individual simple ions. Okay, this Mn reacts with the compounds like FeS which cause hot shortness and decreases the hot shortness. Okay, that is why manganese is beneficial, because it, the, without affecting the ductility, it increases the toughness also. Okay, this is about manganese. It decreases the hot shortness and also increases toughness. Fine. And other nitrogen, hydrogen, all these cause embrittlement. Okay, these, what what happens is these gases, generally nitrogen, hydrogen are gases. This impairs the plastic properties and increases the embrittlement even at the low temperature. Okay, that means it increases the temperature range of the brittle region. I think you have studied about DBDT. So generally what it is exactly saying is it is increasing the DBDT temperature. Okay, so that is what this embrittlement means. So that happens because of gases like nitrogen and hydrogen. So this is the effect of different important impurities that are present in the steel. Okay, so now we'll move on to the steel making processes. We'll see the development of these processes, and then we'll move to the present day modern usage in the integrated steel plants. Okay, so generally, as I already said, there are some developments that are done in the steel making, developments in steel making process. First, the converter used or the process that is used or developed is known as acid Bessemer process. Okay, we'll just briefly look at the different processes that are developed and then see which process is used today. Okay, acid Bessemer process. This is a process in which air is blown. Okay, air is blown in an acid lined pear shaped vessel. Pear shaped vessel is also known as a converter. Okay, this vessel, the pear shaped vessel, I'll draw in the when we are discussing about converter steel making. Okay, acid Bessemer process used air is blew into an acid lined, that means this converter is lined with an acidic oxides or acidic refractories. Here there is no amount of heat supplied, but the main disadvantage of this acid Bessemer process is the sulfur and phosphorus are not removed. The control of this content, sulfur and phosphorus, was not possible. Why? We'll discuss what are the conditions that are required for desulfurization and dephosphorization. From that you will get to know why this acid lining is not useful for the removal of sulfur or phosphorus. Okay, this is the first one, acid Bessemer. Next, basic Bessemer. What is this? Simply the same one, the same process, but with the use of a basic lining, and obviously air is only used here also. So what is the main disadvantage of these two? The one more main disadvantage apart from this is the hydrogen content of the steel is increased to very high level because of this air that is used. Okay, because of air there is more nitrogen, and the solubility of nitrogen in the liquid steel is more, so that embrittlement can easily be taking place in these two type of process. That is the major disadvantage. Okay, next one is open hearth process. Okay, open hearth process. What is this open hearth process? In this, there is some amount of thermal energy supplied. There is some amount of thermal energy supplied through gaseous fuel. We know in blast furnace also coke is the fuel that provides energy on combustion. Similarly, here also there are some fuels, maybe gaseous or liquid, sometimes liquid fuels also, which provide thermal energy. Okay, so that the reaction will taking place. We'll see what are the different reactions that are taking place in the coming videos. Okay, and these are the three processes that are being used, but the latest process which is being used till today is LD converter steel making or LD process. Okay, this LD converter, what is the main disadvantage that I said of basic and acidic Bessemer? the nitrogen content is increasing. So to cut down the nitrogen composition, this oxygen is used with the help of a top lens. Okay. Top lens is nothing but using a lens which has some nozzles. It is a hollow pipe, hollow cylindrical pipe which has nozzle at one end, or multi nozzles are present, through which this oxygen is sent into the pear shaped vessel or LD converter. Okay, so generally this is the major process which is taking place even today also for primary steel making. Okay, so in this steel making, generally pre-treatment is done. Pre-treatment is done so that to remove sulfur or phosphorus. Okay, before going into the LD converter, this used to be done. We'll discuss what is desulfurization and what is dephosphorization and how it is done. Okay, and also what is a ladle? Ladle is a vessel which is used to perform any operation. Okay, we discussed there that in iron making, ladle is something which stores the hot metal and transfers to the steel making units. But here, there are some developments in ladles also, such that it can be used to perform all the ladle treatments, such as any refining, degassing, deoxidation. Okay, so in ladles only, generally these are, and also inclusion engineering. So we'll be discussing all this inclusion engineering, and all these comes under ladle treatments. All these processes are known as ladle treatments. Okay, we'll discuss all this stuff. So in integrated steel plants, we'll see what is the flow chart. Integrated steel plant is nothing but in which there is also co-producing unit. Okay, so firstly blast furnace is used for iron making, then it goes to basic oxygen furnace. This basic oxygen furnace is nothing but the furnace which is used in LD process. Okay, the converter is also known as basic oxygen furnace. Okay, or LD process is also known as BOF process. Always remember this. After this, there are ladle treatments. We have discussed, I just now told what are the different ladle treatments. After this, it goes to continuous casting, where solidification of liquid steel takes place. Okay, until here the desired composition of steel is produced, and later it is sent into continuous casting, where it is solidified, and in rolling the desired dimensions products are obtained. So this is taking place in integrated steel plant, where iron making ke liye blast furnace is used, and similarly BOF or LD process is used in steel making. Fine, this is about in integrated steel plants. Now we'll see in mini steel plants, where generally hot metal is not produced, I mean the plain carbon steels are not produced, but rather alloy steels and some special steels are produced over here. So the main difference between both is there is no blast furnace and there is no steel making unit. Yes, there is a steel making unit, but the furnace or the technology used is electric arc furnace, in which the input is DRI plus scrap, plus some amount of hot metal also. Okay, I'll briefly explain what is EAF and we discuss into the different types. Okay, so this takes place in mini steel plants. Okay, mini steel plants where alloy steels or special steels are produced. Okay, the rest ladle treatments and continuous casting is the same. Okay, this is what happens in mini steel plants, and always remember this sequence, because I think in 2016 or 17 the same question, the same sequence was asked. They jumbled and they asked to pick up a question, I mean option, in integrated steel plant. Okay, so now we'll move into the different steps of steel making. Okay, or different types of steel making. Okay, so here we'll be discussing about all the stuff, primary steel making, secondary steel making, what is done. Usually the primary steel making is nothing but it consists of refining the hot metal, and all the secondary steel making are nothing but the ladle treatments. Okay, so we'll discuss. So generally the concept of this modern steel making in the sense BOF furnace or BOF process or LD process is to make use of steel making vessels. What is this steel making vessel? Steel making vessel is nothing but ladles and tundishes, and also converters. Converter is also a type of vessel that is used here. Okay, converter is nothing but we have discussed where the primary steel making takes place. We'll see what is the primary steel making process. Ladle is nothing but it is used to transfer the molten steel. It transfers the molten steel from steel making to the casting. Okay, after the steel making also it is stabbed into the ladles only. Whereas tundish is nothing but it is to transfer the steel to the mold of the caster, mold of the continuous caster. That means there is a storage type of thing above the mold which is known as tundish, which feeds the steel to the continuous caster. Okay, converter is nothing but it is where the primary steel making takes place. These are the different types of steel making vessels. Now we'll see what is primary steel making and what is secondary steel making. We'll discuss about this thing. So primary steel making is where the refining of hot metal takes place. All are obviously refining only, but here the feed or the raw material in this primary steel making is the hot metal coming from the blast furnace, plus there is some scrap used so that it acts as a coolant and to maintain the temperature. This refining of primary steel making can take place either in BOF or converter or also EAF. We have discussed about EAF, we'll discuss in brief and we'll see the differences between the both. Okay, the main objective here is to refine the hot metal to desired chemistry. Okay, so we'll see what is this BOF or converter steel making. Okay, so we know that reduction is the process that is taking place in iron making, where the ore Fe2O3 is converted into Fe. The oxygen is getting removed, but here we are sending the oxygen. We are using oxygen blowing through this hot metal so that the impurities are getting removed. So the steel making process is an oxidation process. Okay, so the first thing that you have to remember is this thing. Now we'll see the different types of converter steel makings. Okay, so pure oxygen is blown from the top using a water cooled lance. Lance is nothing but a hollow cylindrical chamber, or you can say a hollow cylindrical pipe through which the oxygen is sent. Okay, and there are some nozzles, multi nozzles present at the end, other end. So this is called as top blown steel making. So now we'll see what are the different types of steel making. If this is the vessel, okay, if this is the vessel and this is the lance through which the oxygen is sent, and here these are the nozzles, and this is the steel that is present, the hot metal, sorry. Okay, this is the top blown converter steel making where the pure oxygen is blown from the top. Similarly, there are some more types in which we will discuss the types now. Oxygen is blown from the top, and there is some stirring taking place from the bottom with the use of inert gases like argon. So this is known as combined top and bottom stirring. Okay, That means top blowing and bottom stirring process. And there is a process also in which only bottom blown oxygen is done. That means oxygen is only blown to the bottom. Okay, this is bottom blown. This is top blown. This is top blown and bottom stirred. These are the different types of converter steel making, but this bottom is not popular at all. Why? Because if there is any difference and solidification taking place, these gets easily clogged, and there is no possibility of further oxidation. So generally bottom blown is not usable. So these are the different types of converter steel making, but this top blown thing is the major steel making technique used nowadays. Okay, now we'll move into the different reactions. What are the different reactions that are taking place? Okay, so we know the hot metal composition, we have discussed previously also. The hot metal consists of carbon to about 3.5 to 4%, silica or silicon to about 0.6 to 1%, manganese to about 0.6 to 0.8, phosphorus is again 0.1 to 0.2. so our aim is to reduce these contents. Why we are reducing this content? Because steel has a carbon content of about less than 2.11, and for applications of like low carbon steel it is less than 0.25. so see the difference, how much it is to be reduced. So that is why we are using oxygen and oxidizing these elements that are present in the hot metal. Okay, so now we will see the different reactions. The first thing that happens is oxidation of iron itself. This is known as iron loss, famously called iron loss reaction, because we are losing some iron into the slag. Okay, next, all are different oxidation reactions only. Mono2P plus and also there are some slag metal reactions. These are known as slag metal reactions, where FeO from slag react with carbon. Okay, this is known as manganese recovery reaction. Okay, so these are the different reactions that takes place in the converter. And always remember, here there is no heat produced from outside. The heat produced due to these chemical reactions is sufficient enough to raise the temperature. We know the temperature of the blast furnace hot metal is about 1250 to 1300 degrees Celsius. Okay, this temperature is raised to the tapping temperature of about 1600 degrees because of these reactions. Okay, so there is a very good amount of heat that is produced because of these oxidation reactions. And one more thing that you have to remember is only CO is a gaseous product or gaseous phase. Carbon is removed in the form of a gaseous phase, whereas all the other elements are removed in liquid phases and they form slag. Okay, they form slag. So generally oxygen is blown for 15 to 20 minutes irrespective of the converter capacity. Whatever is the capacity of the volume of the converter, oxygen should be blown only until 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, so this is about converter steel making reactions. Okay, now we'll briefly discuss about EF. I said the other important thing in primary steel making is electric arc furnace. Here there is no blast furnace involved. Directly the hot metal, okay, directly hot metal along with some scrap and DRI or sponge iron is directly used That means these are the raw materials to produce alloy steels. To produce alloy steels. Okay. So here, by the name itself, we can say electric energy is the major source of energy. Electric energy is used and this is converted into a thermal energy. And how this electric energy is produced? It is produced by the help of graphite electrodes. Okay, graphite electrodes are sent from the top, and with the arc produced between the inputs and the graphite electrodes, there is the production of electrical energy and it produces thermal energy also. Okay, so always remember, alloy steels are produced in EAF. So this is about primary steel making, where we are refining all the stuff. Now we move on to the secondary steel making. So what is the secondary steel making? The main objective of this secondary steel making is secondary steel making. Obviously we are using the same refining in primary steel making, but the main objective here is to make the steel of desired chemistry and also cleanliness. Cleanliness is nothing but free of inclusions. It is known as clean steel. Okay, with the help of ladle treatments. All the ladle treatments are the processes done under secondary steel making. That means after the primary steel making, all these ladle treatments are done. So what are these different ladle treatments we are will be discussing now? The first one is to stir the steel. Okay, obviously stirring is done by organ, so that there will be no concentration gradients or temperature gradients. That means this process is known as homogenization. We'll discuss all this stuff later on. Okay, the next one is to produce clean steel, obviously by removing or modifying the inclusions. The next one is deoxidation and also degassing. These are the different ladle treatments that are done, and refining by injecting powders. This is known as injection metallurgy. Injecting. Okay, so these are the different processes that are done in secondary steel making. So obviously we said that, we have discussed that ladle treatments. From the name itself we can say that maximum of all these stuff, all these process will be taking place in ladles. And to carry out in ladles, obviously the resident time in ladles will be more. That means the steel should be staying in the ladles for more time, and there is a chance of solidification. Yes, because of the resident time, there is a chance of solidification because of the room temperature. So to avoid that, there is a development which has, there is a development in ladles which have additional heating facility. Additional heating facility to the ladle itself. These are known as ladle furnaces. Okay, these are known as ladle furnaces. Fine. So the ladles which have additional heating facilities are known as ladle furnaces. So with this we can form the steel of desired composition, desired chemistry, and now this is going to follow continuous casting and rolling, or you can call finishing. Okay, where the molten steel is being casted into billets, blooms or slabs depending on the product that they need. Okay, that means long or flat products are formed on solidification. Okay, in this continuous casting, whereas in finishing there is mechanical deformation taking place like rolling, forging or any heat treatment, surface treatments that are required to the steel, that is done in the finishing. Okay, so this is done after the steel making process. So now, from the next lecture, we'll be studying about all the steel making stuff, primary steel making, secondary steel making, what are the conditions that are required to remove any type of element, impurity element. We'll be studying all those things. So stay tuned. I hope to complete all the steel making lectures by the end of this month. So stay subscribed and please give me a like so that it motivates me to do frequent videos on many other topics after the completion of steel making. And please do share our Everything Metallurgy to your great friends so that they can get benefited from this. So thank you guys.